We welcome you all for the second session of this course. It is my proud privilege to introduce you all with our eminent expert, Professor Pramod Kumar Singla sir. Sir is at present holding the position of Faculty Administration in Charge at NITA Chandigarh and also Associate Professor in the Department of Education and Educational Management. Sir possesses B.Tech degree in the branch of civil engineering, M.E. in irrigation and hydraulics, and pursuing Ph.D. from Punjab University, Chandigarh. Before joining to our department EMGT, sir also served curriculum development department of NITA Chandigarh and contributed a lot by designing and revising 90 plus different curriculums for the different branches of engineering. Sir has immensely contributed in research literature and published 10 papers in international journals, 15 papers in national journals, and also act as a keynote speaker in many conferences in India and abroad. Sir, area of specialization is appropriate low-cost technology, curriculum development, areas related to the branch of civil engineering, communication skills, and personality development. In the 34 years of experience in teaching and 30 years of experience in research, sir has immensely contributed in the terms of transfer technology in the branch of engineering also and introduced 20 different technologies. Sir has also published 8 different books for various disciplines related to management, curriculum, and communication skills. At present, sir is holding the position of Faculty Administration in Charge. As far as this particular session is concerned, from the biodata, I think you all may be surprised that how an engineer is able to deliver a talk on human values and ethics. When you come to NITA Chandigarh and have a chance to meet sir, you come to know that he is a person who possesses all the qualities of being humble, despite of the various authority positions handled by sir at NITA Chandigarh. And sir always put the needs of other person first. So the personality like this who not only possesses all kind of specialization of the respective branch and other interdisciplinary area, but he is an example that how a human can hold certain values and ethics when he is working in a professional era. So thank you very much, Singla sir, for accepting our invitation and interacting with all the participants. So over to you, sir.
A very good morning to everyone and namaskar. Amandeep Kaur happens to be a very dear and very dedicated colleague and a very dear friend also. In our institute, we have an excellent work culture where every faculty is quite aware about their responsibilities. As she mentioned in my introduction, I do not really actually have to do many things as administrator because everybody is doing sincerely their jobs. I simply try to facilitate people. Thank you so much, Amandeep, for such an elaborate and such a big introduction, I would say. And when you introduce the speaker in such words, such kind words, the onus, the responsibility on the speaker increases to prove, to come up to the expectations of the participants. My dear friends, thank you very much for joining the session, and thanks to my dear colleague and friend Dr. Sunil Dutt for choosing me one of the speakers in this program. I always like to be in academics besides the time which I spent in the administration. Now, without much ado about the introductory parts, I will like to straightway come to the topic of ethics and values. This topic is very, very dear to me. I will be covering some aspects of health and happiness also, because the complete topic is health, ethics and values, health and happiness. The topic is so vast, I am not sure whether I will be able to do justice to the complete topic, but I will try to cover some of the very important things which my colleagues from engineering colleges and polytechnic colleges will be able to appreciate. I have also brought one or two video films with me. If the time will permit, I will try to show those films to you all. Manisha ma'am, if you say, I can start my लेक्चर विद द वीडियो फिल्म इटसेल्फ. मैं इसको बंद करके शेयर उस पे जाता हूँ. यस
श्योर सर, श्योर सर.
ओके वर्ड की फाइल लोड हो रही है अभी. ये फाइल दिखाई दे रही है मैम?
जी सर.
माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू रीड इट, आई विल शो द वीडियो इज जस्ट अ फ्यू सेकंड्स ओनली. द स्पोर्ट्समैन स्पिरिट, द फेयर प्ले. फेयर मींस इट्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सॉट आफ्टर वैल्यू एंड एवरी एथिकल स्कूल ऑफ थॉट्स डू लॉट ऑफ एम्फेसिस ऑन बीइंग फेयर. एंड दिस इज अ वीडियो ऑफ द स्पोर्ट्स ग्राउंड of football match in 2003 in a game between Denmark and Iran. Denmark and Iran, but they were playing a football match. An Iranian player mistook a whistle from the crowd. Somebody whistled in the crowd and the Iranian player thought that this is a whistle from the referee and that it is a halftime signal. Now, when there is a halftime signal, then the referee give you whistle. But the whistle was not from referee, it was from the crowd. And picked up the ball with his hands. Usne apni penalty area ke andar, apne haathon mein ball utha li. He picked up the ball, thinking that it is now halftime. But then it was not a halftime, it was a whistle from the audience. So the referee gave Denmark penalty kick to the Denmark against the Iranian player. But then the following consultation with the national team coach, Morten Olsen, Denmark people knew that it was a mistake. It was not a deliberately he picked up the football by hand, but it was a by chance that he mistook the whistle of the audience with the referee. So Denmark people thought it is not fair that we give him a plenty stroke. They could have made a goal. It is like a plenty stroke means it is a golden opportunity. But they consulted their coach, whose name was Morten Olsen. Morten Weghorst, jis player ne plenty stroke lena tha, uska name tha Morten Weghorst. He missed the plenty on purpose. Usne deliberately wo goal karne ki bajaye, when he took the penalty stroke, he pushed the ball out of the poles so that it is a fair player. They want to win the penalty stroke by playing, not by simply misunderstanding of the Iranian player. So this is the plot, and now you will see the the video also. Isme, should I play? Kindly watch it very carefully. It is a very small video. Thank you. So, my dear friends, this is a small video clip which shows and Denmark lost that match by 1-0. They had the opportunity to make the goal, but they missed the goal deliberately, simply because they felt that it will be unfair to take a mistake of the other opponent team as a opportunity to make the goal. Nisha ma'am, main ab slides pe aana hai mereko aise isko. How do I come to the slides again? मैं ऑप्शन नहीं आ रही मेरे पास ना अनशेयर करने वाली.
सर इसको ऊपर जहाँ पे आ रहा है ना डेनमार्क वर्सेस ईरान वहाँ पे क्रॉस का निशान आएगा इफ यू कुड जस्ट होवर ओवर इट.
नहीं वो आ नहीं रहा मैं नहीं देख रहा था.
सर एक मिनट में क्या करती हूँ आई विल मेक मायसेल्फ द प्रेजेंटर फर्स्ट.
इसको भी मैंने बंद करना है इस स्लाइड ये वाले.
हाँ जी सर मैं कर देती हूँ. Sir, I'm making you the presenter again.
Okay. पहले मैं वो स्लाइड को खोल लेता हूँ.
हाँ जी. Yes.
And then I share the screen now. अब आ रही है आपको?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, friends. With this small video, you will understand what was at stake. Denmark could have very easily scored because plenty stroke is as good as you are getting a lollipop, and they refused to take that lollipop because they wanted to be fair. They want to earn the goal, not by mistake of the opponent. My dear friends, with this video, we will go ahead with this now our presentation here. अब ये फुल स्क्रीन पे आ रही है ना मैम?
यस सर.
ओके माय डियर फ्रेंड्स आई लाइक टू हैव ए प्लेज फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ यू दैट फ्रॉम दिस मोमेंट टिल नेक्स्ट वन आवर एंड हाफ यू टेल योरसेल्फ एंड प्रॉमिस मी दैट आई एम ए सीकर यू वांट टू लर्न समथिंग आई हैव ए पेन एंड पेपर यू आर द स्टूडेंट्स राइट नाउ यू मे बी अटेंडिंग द सेशन फ्रॉम योर होम्स or from your offices, but you must carry a pen and a paper like any other student. When you expect from your students that they should always carry a pen and paper, you must carry also and take the notes wherever you feel you should be taking the notes. And I am going to make my notes and I will use them. Not only make the notes, but also use those notes. And notes taking is very important in our teaching learning process. You may be taking physical notes on the pen and paper, using pen and paper, or you may be taking mental notes, but nevertheless you must apply that these things in your everyday life. And I want to learn. Come and have this attitude of that you want to learn something, even if I will be talking not so many things which are not which are very very new to you, but then it is a constant reminder to you, all of you, and to myself also. Even we need to remember and recall all those things, and with a learning attitude we can go ahead with the session now. I like to start my session by this quote by Potter Stewart. He said, ethics is knowing the difference between what you have a right to do and what is right to do. Kindly focus on this slide, my dear friends. एथिक्स इज नोइंग द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वॉट यू हैव आपका आपके राइट्स क्या हैं आपके प्रिविलेजेस क्या हैं एंड वॉट इज द राइट थिंग टू डू ठीक क्या है वट इज द करेक्ट थिंग टू डू इन ए सिचुएशन तो दिस इज वॉट द एथिक इज ऑल अबाउट एंड आई लाइक टू कोट फ्रॉम स्वामी विवेकानंद ही सेड दैट नो नेशन कैन बिकम ग्रेट. ये स्लाइड कैसे कैसे खत्म होगी ये ऊपर से जो आ रहा है. आई टेक इट ग्रेट. ओके ठीक है आप आपको No nation can become great or achieve prosperity without its people developing a sense of self-discipline, social responsibility, and cooperative work attitude. So, if we want our nation, India, to become a developed nation, we have been developing nation for a long time. We are underdeveloped, and we then for a long, long time, for many, many years now, decades now, the country who got their freedom during our times when we got in 47 or even after that, they have already come to the bracket of developed nation. But we are still developing because as per Swami Vivekananda, we require our people, people means you and me, we are included in that, to be self-disciplined, social responsibility and cooperative work at it. If you understand this quote, my dear friends, I think my 90% of session on ethics and work is covered. And great leaders create a few non-negotiable ethics and values for the organizations which they follow strictly. Now, understand this concept very well, my dear friends. Great leaders, you may be the leaders of your classroom and your HODs, or if you are the HOD, you are the leaders of your department. Your director or your principal is the leader of your polytechnic or engineering college or the university. Similarly, at the state level, at the country level, we have the leaders. Non-negotiable ethics and values. Jiske upar koi compromise nahi hoga. Everybody will have to abide. Those of you who have visited the developed nation, so-called, you will find that it is so clinical. The rules and regulations are so clinical. People automatically, irrespective of their positions, irrespective of their situation and circumstances, they do not negotiate on them. When there is a red light, even if there is no policeman standing at the roundabout, people stop. And then people, wait for their turn. And if there is a queue, bus stop ke samne queue lagi hui hai passengers ki, people will not jump the queue. Non-negotiable ethics and values. I am just giving you very grassroots, very simple examples to bring home the fact why those nations are developed and why we are developing nations. Because we wait for the chalan person, that policeman to stop us in spite of the red light. And at many cross sections and in the streets, there is no red lights. Only a small board is written. Stop, watch, and then proceed. People like to stop their car, they watch all around, and then they proceed. Even when there is no traffic, even when there is no policeman, there are no red lights. There are no traffic signals. So that kind of ethics and values the people follow. If you have to be disciplined, non-negotiable ethics and values. And this is applicable not only on the roadside, in our classrooms, in our wherever we are working, wherever we are moving, they go with us. Ratan Tata, I am giving you one quote from Ratan Tata ji also. Apart from values and ethics, which I have tried to live by, Ratan Tata said that apart from the values and ethics which I have tried to live by, the legacy of J.R.D. Tata, which he is talking about, the legacy I would like to leave behind is a very simple one. What is that? What he wants his next generation to follow, which he followed from J.R.D. Tata, that I have always stood up for what I consider to be right thing. Ratan Tata have always stood up for the things which he thinks that it is a right thing. And I have tried to be as fair and equitable as I could be. We have so many rich persons in the world. But then I have taken the example from our own corporate tycoon, Ratan Tata ji. And it is a known fact that JRD Tata, I have gone to Tata Institute, IISc, Bangalore number of times to present my papers and to attend some meetings also. I was told when I went there first time that JRD Tata never ever bribed anyone, even a single penny, to get unfair advantage from any government official. It is a role model for us. We normally feel that business without corruption is not possible. But here is a person, Ratan Tata, son of JRD Tata, who is following his legacy, and he want to pass on this legacy to his next generation and his industry people. So these are the ethics and values. Now, my dear friends, I like to share with you few definitions here, few concepts. We talk about the high morals, ethics, virtues, righteous, noble. Take the basic definitions first, then we will go in the details also. Morals, इसको हिंदी में कहते हैं नैतिक. हमारे नैतिक अधिकार क्या हैं और नैतिक कर्तव्य क्या हैं? Morals. It is opposite to immoral. What is not moral, immoral is moral. Sometimes when we talk in terms of communication, opposite words clarify the word itself. ये नहीं है. Moral is not being immoral. It is conforming to a standard. What is good and right? So ethics and values cover these morals also. And what is ethical? Ethical is achar vichar, niti shastra, niti shastra. Involvement of more subtle questions of rightness, fairness, and or equity. It is a question of rightness, what is right, and what is fair, and what is applicable to everyone, equity. The virtues, it is dharmic or bhadra. हिंदी में इसको इसका ट्रांस
और दिस इन अ नोटपैड इन माय ऑन माय टेबल इसकी कितनी वैल्यू है 10 रुपीस या 15 सो हाउ मच वैल्यू यू गिव टू अ थिंग और टू अ कंसेप्ट आप कितना महत्व देते हो कितनी अहमियत देते हो इन एथिक्स वैल्यू डिनोट द डिग्री ऑफ इंपॉर्टेंस आप उसको कितनी इंपॉर्टेंस दे रहे हो of something or action. आप उस action को कितनी importance दे रहे हो? With the aim of determining what actions are best to do and what way is the best to live. आपके पास choices हैं. At any given time, you have so many choices in my life, in your life. You can do this, you can do this. Red light है, आपके पास choice है. You can jump the red light or you can stop. Choice. आप कितनी अहमियत देते हो अपने एक्शन को कि दिस इज द राइट थिंग टू डू और दिस इज द राइट थिंग टू डू यू मे जस्टिफाई योर सेल्फ मैं तो जल्दी में हूं एवरीबॉडी इज इन द हरी इफ एवरीबॉडी स्टार्ट जंपिंग द लाइट नोबडी विल रीच द डेस्टिनेशन डे विल कम व्हेन एवरीबॉडी विल बी देयर विल बी अ जैम देयर विल बी एक्सीडेंट्स देयर विल बी डेथ्स देयर विल बी फैटलिटीज सो वी आर टॉकिंग वी आर लिविंग नाउ इन ए टाइम्स when there is a pandemic of Corona 19, if every one of our citizens pay attention to the principles of being a fellow being, I mean, fellow being means anybody who's in my neighborhood. chat box now. What do you understand by the word ethic is? Before I give you my definition of ethics. Yes, my dear colleagues, I like to know from you what are the ethics. Maybe one or two inputs you can start writing on the chat book. Our moral duties. Yes. Udayveer Singh ji ne kaha ke moral values, do what is right. And Ranjit ji ne kaha ke our moral duties. Somebody else? What are ethics? There is no fixed definition, my dear friends, of ethics. We'll try to have a concept. Moral responsibilities. Vikram ji ne kaha ki be kind and truth oneself to other and others. Udayveer ji ne aur likha ki ethics are guiding principles. Okay. Neelam, belief of what is morally right or wrong. Ethics are doing no harm to others and truthful. Okay. ये मेरे को लगता है अमनदीप ने लिखा है ये डूइंग नो हार्म बिकॉज इट इज शोइंग ईएमजीटी डिपार्टमेंट टू ऑन पैनलिस्ट
सर सम ऑफ द पार्टिसिपेंट्स मैसेज टू द होस्ट सो आई जस्ट कॉपी एंड
ओके 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 थैंक यू सो मच मनीषा ओके माय डियर फ्रेंड्स यू आर वेरी क्लोज टू इट मेरा दिल कर रहा है कि मैं आपके से और सुनूं और आपसे और लर्न करूं बिकॉज टीचिंग इज अ प्रोफेशन ऑफ लर्निंग but then time is not permitting me to go for further discussions. I require minimum 4 to 5 hours to cover this topic, but nevertheless, we'll try to learn from each other. So what are the ethics? And whatever you have given your inputs is very valuable and true also. You are very, very right. But let me clarify this concept very little more further on this. A discipline dealing with what is good and bad, and with moral duty and obligation. It is duty and your obligation, okay, under any situation. A set of moral principles or values. I have covered the definition, so I am not going in the details. The principles of conduct governing an individual or a group. Up individually, or when you are working in a group, or when you are behaving in a group, those principles of conduct is very important, and we all have the code of conduct. We have the constitution. That is why in the new education policy there is a lot of emphasis on understanding the constitution of India, so that people are aware of how they have to conduct themselves in individually as well as in the group, and conforming to accepted, especially professional standard of conduct. Every organization have their written or unwritten standards of conduct expected from the employees. So jo aapke employees ke conduct hain, kuch expectations hai aapki organization ki. Similarly in the country, aapke country ki kuch expectations hain. Conforming to accepted, especially professional standard of conduct. In many organizations they have the written code of conduct also. For engineers, if you go to the site of Institution of Engineers, you will find the code of conduct for every engineer in this country. Code of conduct for every engineer, whether you are AMI or you are BTech or you are MTech or whatever degree you are possessing, code of conduct is given there. Kindly go through that. Ethics means character, norms, morals, and ideas prevailing in a group or the society. Ethic may be referred to as some standardized form of conduct behavior of individuals understood and accepted in a particular field of activity. Jaise for example, aapne ek rule banaya game khelne ke liye. Everyone who are playing are following those rules. And there are so many sports where there are no umpires closely watching you. I belong to that sport myself. Sailing is a sport, we have the umpires, but when you are actually sailing in the water, that is why there is a phrase in English language, fair sailing.
because that is a sport where the umpires or the referees are not closely watching you whether you are following the rules or no. You yourself have to conduct or behave. You have to understand and accept and behave like that. Ethics. Now, kindly go through the definition. Ethics is a mass of moral principles or set of values about what conduct ought to be, how your conduct should be, how you should behave and act. Set of values and moral principles. They give an idea what is right and what is wrong, what is true and what is false, what is fair and what is unfair, what is just and what is unjust, what is proper or what is improper. Imagine. And each one of us, we do not require referees all the time, whether we are at home, whether we are in the market, whether we are in the classroom, whether we are in the playground, we do not require, we cannot have so many referees. Each one of us have that referee in the name of our own consciousness. Listen to that still small voice and you will know what is right or wrong, what is true or false, what is fair or unfair, what is just or unjust, what is proper or improper. For example, honesty, obedience, equality, fairness, respect, and then doing the right thing. Respect yourself and give respect to others. Not only by bowing your hand, by collapsing your hand, by saying namaste or by dandavat, but respecting the opinions, the point of view of the other people also. Right or wrong is not a concern, but respecting, they have certain opinions, they have certain understandings, respect them. You may or may not agree with them, but then giving respect to them, giving respect to each and every law and every rule is basically ethics. I will like to share some more basic things here now. Decency is very important in conducting yourself in an organization. Sabhya, shisht, uchit, one has to be. जो उचित है. Now, we all know in any situation what is उचित and what is अनुचित क्या है. And what is the definition of decency? Appropriate, well formed, handsome. Handsome is not your only physical outlook, but your acts. And modest. This is how the decency is defined. And to conduct yourself decently is what ethic is all about. Having praiseworthy qualities. Now another concept is purity. Shud. हमने हालांकि कवर करा था शुरू में, but I like to define purity is a very important concept in ethics and values. We say so and so person is very pure. इसमें कोई दोष नहीं है. एक दूध का ग्लास है, इसमें कोई अडल्ट्रेशन नहीं है. Similarly, in our characters, I am निर्दोष और you are निर्दोष. It means मेरे कैरेक्टर में कोई दोष नहीं है, शुद्ध है. Characterized by no appreciable alteration. कोई उसमें अडल्ट्री नहीं है. Unmixed by any other matter. Free from dust, tint or taint. उसमें कोई बल नहीं है. कार की एक शीट है पर आपकी कोई भी कार का सरफेस है, उसमें कोई डेंट नहीं है, कोई डस्ट नहीं है, कोई डेंट नहीं है, कोई टेंट नहीं है. दिस ग्लास इज अनटेंटेड ग्लास. इसमें कोई खराबी नहीं है. व्हेन यू सी द मिरर में अपना इमेज देखते हैं, देयर इज नो टेंटेड इमेज यू आर सीइंग. सो योर कैरेक्टर शुड बी लाइक दैट, बिकॉज द स्टूडेंट्स आर द for students, you are the role model. If there are taint, dust or dint in your character, it will be reflected in the mirror, that is the your students. Spotless, koi daag nahi hai. Stainless, koi stain nahi hai, koi us pe nishan nahi. That is the character I'm talking about. Of pure blood and unmixed ancestry. These are very, very important things. I will not go in the details, so I can give a full one lecture on what is pure blood and unmixed ancestry. Koi unke khandan mein daag nahi hai. Earlier, you know, when we used to do the matchmaking, we used to not see the outer beauty or how much money or what is the financial, uska rutba kya hai financially, economically, society mein. People used to go for the purity. Uska khandan mein koi daag to nahi. That is why the institution of marriage used to last forever in our ancestors. You can understand the implications of ethics and values in our social life also, besides in our personal and professional lives. Free from moral fault or guilt. Guilt bhi nahi. Then, my dear friends, I like to share with you one concept of poise, being poised. We say so-and-so person is very poised soul. Santulan. Poise means santulan. Jaldi se wo vichlit nahi ho jata. Usko thoda sa prolaban diya. Kaha ke bhi hum aapko kal ko ye bana denge, yadi aap ye kar denge. Okay? I call a person in my office and say ke kal ko hum aapko ye just do. Have to compromise only on small things. Atam vishwas hai uske andar. A poised person is so balanced, he will not be easily moved by small, petty, mean things. Balance, equilibrium, self-possessed composer, assurance and dignity. Thoda sa dukh aaya aur uska equilibrium bigad gaya and he is ready to do anything to come out of that situation. No, we don't want this kind of person. They can very easily be going against the ethics and values. Wise person. Self-composed. Jaldi se dukh aata hai, sukh bhi aata hai. Jaldi se vichlit nahi hota. Calm. Serene. Serene means clear and free from storm. जिंदगी में उतार चढ़ाव जो स्टॉर्म्स आते हैं अनप्लेजेंट सिचुएशंस आती हैं ही इज शाइनिंग ब्राइट एंड स्टेडी काम एंड ट्रैंक्विल दीज आर द बेसिकली टर्म्स व्हिच डिफाइन ए पर्सन पर्सनालिटी हु इज पॉइस ट्रैंक्विल मींस फ्री फ्रॉम एजिटेशन डिस्टर्बेंस और टर्मोइल क्वाइट शांत है स्टेडी स्टेबल कुछ भी गम आए कुछ कुछ प्रॉब्लम आती हैं ही ट्रैंक्विल अज्यूमिंग ए स्टेट ऑफ पॉइस दीज आर द पीपल हु आर एबल टू वैल्यू एंड रिफ्लेक्ट एथिकल बिहेवियर इन द सोसाइटी इन द प्रोफेशन इन देयर होम्स आल्सो देन डिवोट Of late, many people have different connotations related to dharmic or devout, but then understand what dharmic means, a devoted. Who does not want to have a devoted employee under him? Who does not want to have a devoted student? Who does not want to have a devoted maid in the home? Jo apne kaam ki taraf devoted ho, sincere ho. Religious duties and exercises. Religious, again, this is again a term which is oftenly misunderstood by people, but it is so very important. Religious duties and then sanctify. Sanctify means pavitra, shuddhata. Sanctify means consecrate, free from sin. To give moral and social sanction to. And my dear friends, after this basics, now I'll come to the work ethics. और एथिक्स में डूज एंड डोंट्स का बड़ा एम्फेसिस है. तो पर्सनली आई डू नॉट बिलीव इन डूज एंड डोंट्स, बट देन व्हेन यू राइट डाउन द कोड ऑफ एथिक्स फॉर एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दे बिकम सो वेरी हैंडी टू बी ए गाइडलाइन फॉर इट्स एम्प्लॉयर फॉर देयर एम्प्लॉयज टू फॉलो. ये करना है ये नहीं करना. सुबह 9 बजे ऑफिस आना है, 9 o'clock यू हैव टू रिपोर्ट टू द ड्यूटी. 9:15 नहीं आना, 9:10 पे नहीं आना. ओके, सो व्हाट आर द वर्क एथिक्स? डूज क्या हैं? डूज आर द रिक्वायरिंग मेंबर्स टू डू थिंग्स दैट आर मॉरली गुड और राइट. मॉरली गुड एंड राइट, गुड भी हैं और राइट भी हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल पंचुअलिटी, कर्टसी. फ्रॉम चौकीदार टू डायरेक्टर यू रिफ्लेक्ट कर्टसी इन योर बिहेवियर इज बेसिकली वन शुड व्हाट इज एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम एनी एम्प्लॉय. एफिशिएंसी, ही इज नॉट प्रोकेस्टिनेट नहीं कर रहा काम को, एफिशिएंटली अपनी ड्यूटी को डिस्चार्ज कर रहा है. हार्ड वर्क, सिंसियरिटी, डिवोशन टू ड्यूटी, रेगुलरिटी, रेगुलरली, नॉट दैट वन टाइम आई हैव डन दिस थिंग, एवरी टाइम. एक बार मैं लाल लाइट के ऊपर खड़ा हो गया था तो दैट गिव्स मी नाउ प्रिविलेज टू बी जंपिंग द लाइट नेक्स्ट टाइम. नो, रेगुलरली, एवरी टाइम, रेगुलरली यू हैव टू. डिसिप्लिन, प्रॉम्प्टनेस, एंटरप्राइज. Enterprise means not only setting up a new business, there is a term called enterprise, entrepreneurial. Entrepreneurial is in the organization what new things you are trying to discover or project to bring about more efficiency and more productivity for the organization. And initiative, what new things you are initiating, not only complacent with the things status quo when you are new initiative you are taking. So these are only some examples of do's: punctuality, courtesy, efficiency, hard work, sincerity, devotion to duty, regularity, discipline, promptness, enterprise, and initiative. Work ethics. They apply in every situation, my dear friends. Things that are morally good and right to do, whether it is your home, whether it is a marketplace, public place. Marketplace to me is public place, or wherever you are working. What is right to do and what is good? What are the qualities of a good teacher? Good to do and right thing to do. Then, work ethics में कुछ don'ts भी हैं. अपने आप को restrain करना, और you restrain your employees from doing things that are morally bad and wrong, which are morally bad हैं और which are wrong, opposite to what the do's are. For example, insubordination. You will respect your senior. I say you respect everyone, but at least your insubordination means you do not break the hierarchy of the system. You do not jump out of your position. So you can take the initiative, but insubordination नहीं होना चाहिए. Lethargy and indolence. Indolence means do not want to work or unaccountable. Uncountable means you आपकी accountability नहीं है. Indolence means you do not want to. कोई काम नहीं करेंगे, गलती नहीं करेंगे. Some people have this principle in their mind. They have a indolence attitude that they don't want to do any work. They give a excuse to themselves that by not doing a work, I am not doing any mistake. By not doing a work is a mistake in itself. You are entering into indolence and corruption, dishonesty. These are, I mean, there can be full lectures on corruption, there can be full lecture on dishonesty, there can be full lectures on this body, praying and making all efforts. I'm not saying all of us, but then largely, large mass of population is indulging in. Why? Because now education is synonym with examination, employment, empowerment. Mereko kitni power. I am going to be bureaucrat. I have seen so many engineers, doctors taking my own family members maybe. They want to take the IAS positions, come to yourself because of empowerment. Why should there be any empowerment to any position? It does not stand for emancipation. People used to go for to the Rishi Munis for mukti. Emancipation was the purpose, but now it is examination. Kitne number aayenge, kaun si job milegi, kitni meko power milegi. It is not ennoblement, nobility in the character. Wo ab hamara udeshya nahi raha. Evolution. These three used to be the governing principle of the student life. Kisi bhi Rishi Muni ka jo ashram tha, uska rutba kitna uncha rahega. वो डिपेंड करता था कि उसके अंदर बच्चों में इमेंसिपेशन, इनोबलमेंट एंड एवोल्यूशन की कैपेसिटी कितनी कैपेसिटी है. नाउ द रुतबा क्या है कि उसका कितने मार्क्स, कितने पैकेज दिलाने वाला इंस्टीट्यूट है ये, कितनी एम्पावरमेंट दिलाने वाला, कितने लोग वहां से आईएएस निकल रहे हैं, ब्यूरोक्रेट्स और द लीडर्स सो कॉल्ड. एजुकेशन टुडे, my dear friends, I'll skip the slides. What exactly is the true meaning of education? Does education make one wiser, happier, or contented? Now, my dear friends, I'm touching upon certain things on the happiness also here. If you are not contented, whatever accumulation of material you may have, you will never be happy. Is your education making, is its aim to make you wiser, or stuffing of information and knowledge and then examination? Where is the wisdom? Are you imparting wisdom, or are you imparting knowledge and information to the students? This is what is our curriculum is revolves now. I am happy that our new education policy is laying a lot of emphasis on this. But then if we are able to translate that policy into action, into curriculum and in our classrooms, then only we will be able to see transformation in our students and in our society. Education, my dear friends, kindly read these red letter words here. Education is really the process of removing the ignorance that is covering our inner knowledge, which is absolute, which is perfect, which is eternal, and which is supreme. Our role is whatever seed is already there, whatever the tree is already inside the tree seed, only to nurture that seed so that it becomes a tree, which is inner knowledge, absolute, perfect, eternal, and supreme. Leading our student to holistic life and entertaining the values. Now, what are those values? I like to know again from my friends here. Come to the chat box and meri awaaz nahi ja rahi aap logon ke tak. Some people say, नीलम के पास मेरी आवाज नहीं है. शी हैज सर्टेन के मे बी सम इशू विद हर सिस्टम. आई लाइक टू नो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, मे बी सम इशू फ्रॉम इंटरनेट इशू फ्रॉम हर साइड, और मे बी यू कैन गिव द वॉल्यूम. आई एम स्पीकिंग एट क्वाइट ए लाउड वॉइस हियर. ऑडियो इज बैक अगेन सर. थैंक यू सो मच नीलम जी फॉर योर फीडबैक. नीलम उपाध्याय, आई लाइक टू नो व्हाट आर द वैल्यूज. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द टर्म वैल्यू? Core principle. Alka Avasthi has written core principle. Okay, somebody else? मैंने काफी सारी डेफिनेशन भी दिया. व्हाट आर द वैल्यूज, वी टॉक अबाउट वैल्यू एजुकेशन. ट्रू इमोशनल इम्पोर्टेंस, उदय वीर सिंह जी. Core, Alka ji, core principles embodied upon us by family. Okay, and the definition of family is not limited to our, you know, blood relations only. The whole universe is my kutum hai hamara sara. Okay, anyway, Alka ji, very beautiful. Thank you so much. Worth, Shri Devi ji has written, Kulkarni has written worth. The worth you attach to a thing, okay. And then Anil Dhawan ji said emotional intelligence. Okay, emotional intelligence. Somebody else. I am little selfish, you know. In my classroom, I like to always learn. I don't come to my classroom to teach. I like come to my classroom to learn. So I always steal away some time to learn from all of you. Importance of moral actions. Neelam ji has written, okay. I am seeing so many participants, they are silently listening or they are on the mother mode. Respect to others and self, patience. Yes, this is written by Divyam, okay. Then Ishan has significance of punctuality. Yeah, punctuality is one of the things. Yes, very, very nice. Belongingness. Oh, wow, wonderful. Vishwajit Bhatia, Bhattacharya has written, Vishwajit Bhattacharya has written, belongingness. You feel your belongingness to a organization. For example, if I feel belongingness to this institute, if a tap is on in the bathroom, my value system says go and close the tap so that our water bill is not increased. Number two, that water is required by many people. Jahan pe pani nahi pahunch raha. So you have a sense of belongingness to your organization. On the red lights also, you have a belongingness to the people around you. In your home, you have a sense of belongingness. So wonderful, Bishwajit ji. Okay, somebody else? I really enjoy my classrooms with a lot of noise, but I cannot unmute you, my dear friends. Manisha ji knows very well ki itne bade group ko unmute karke fir control karna mushkil ho jayega. So normally I like noisy classrooms jahan pe bahut sari awaazein aaye, log kehte sir mere ko batana hai, mere ko batana hai. Okay, if there are no more comments here, or there are some comments, but probably I need to scroll down. Self-conscious behavior, adhering to values. From Prabha, self-conscious behavior. Okay, my dear friends, coming back to my slides again, focus on this. We try to explore it together here. What are values? Values are standards. Iski standard value kitni hai? You know, एक के जी शुड बी वन के जी. यदि आपका जो बट्टा है, पंजाबी में उसको बट्टा कहते हैं, जो आपका जो वेट है वो कैलिब्रेटेड प्रॉपरली है कि नहीं है. सो कैलिब्रेशन ऑफ योर करेक्टर इज द वैल्यू विच यू आर हैविंग. काइंडली कंसिडर इट वेरी वेल माई डियर फ्रेंड्स. प्रिंसिपल्स कंसिडर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट इन लाइफ. प्रिंसिपल्स विच आर कंसिडर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट इन लाइफ. आपका जो कैलिब्रेशन हुई है. And my dear friends, all of you are doing the calibration of your students in your classrooms based on the principles coming from within or being practiced. So I will talk about those things. Why values? They bring quality and meaning to life. They help you in identifying yourself with certain characters. And many times I find a very common problem with our youth that they're confronting with identity crisis. They do not have identity. They want to characterize themselves with some identity, and they are not having that. Guidelines, they make us realize what we are is more important than what we have. Possessions are important, but more important than possession is what we really are. Are we healthy? When we say healthy, means our state of mind, our body, physical body, and our thinking, our emotional self, and our energy. Values from within, जो आपके अंदर की values हैं, वो क्या हैं? Kindness, compassion, capacity to mercy, forgive others unconditionally, forgive and forget. You are not entitled to mercy, you are not entitled to compassion, you are not entitled to kindness, love, any of these values, sympathy or empathy, if you are not exercising them for others. First of all, love yourself, be kind to yourself, be compassionate, be sympathy, be empathetic to your own self, and then you can give to others. So I can give again 1 hour lecture on each one of them. But then, my dear friend, these are the values from inside you, which is reflected in your outward behavior, your outward reflection to others, how you reflect, how people perceive you. Values to be practiced, जो आपकी दिनचर्या में डे इन एंड डे आउट में प्रैक्टिस करने वाली जो वैल्यूज हैं, दे आर पीपल मेंशनड इन देयर चैट हियर, पंचुअलिटी, डिसिप्लिन, ओबीडियंस, बिहेवियर, कंडक्ट, करेक्टर, दीज हैव टू बी प्रैक्टिस्ड. एंड इफ यू इन ऑर्डर टू प्रैक्टिस देम, what is within you, I have given you the list of those in inner values, and then once you have that, you will be able to practice these values. And then I like to go a little more academically now. Types of values, there can be instrumental values, there can be terminal values. Instrumental values are the processes, the way, जो रास्ता है आपका, road, the journey, and terminal value is the end point, the station. आपका आपकी journey जो है from Chandigarh to Delhi, Chandigarh to Bombay, वो कैसी हो, और आप Bombay पहुंच रहे हैं, आपका destination वो क्या है, both are very important. जो रास्ता आपका ठीक नहीं है, you will never be able to reach your destination. So your instrumental values and your terminal values, both are very important. There are two types of values. What are the instrumental values? Let us try to see. Assertiveness, don't be aggressive, be assertive. I can give again full lecture in my lectures on communication skills. I say be assertive, but not being aggressive, being reflective, not being reactive. Being helpful are the instrumental values. If you are assertive, you will reach somewhere. If you are being helpful to other, you are reaching to those terminal values. Dependability, if people can trust you, these are instrumental values. You can see yourself, am I dependable, or I am not, I am a person who cannot be depended upon. Education and intellectual pursuits are the intellectual are the instrumental values. Hard work and achievement, again instrumental values include obedience, open mindedness, how receptive you are to the ideas of others. You will be able to respect others only when you are open minded, aur aapka mind close hai, puri tarah se box. सेल्फ सफिशियंसी, कंटेंटमेंट की बात हो रही है यहाँ पे. ऑनेस्टी, being well-mannered. These are the instrumental values. They are not the terminal values. Terminal values, aap tabhi pahunch payenge when your instrumental values are adhered to, when you follow the instrumental values. Now I'll talk about the terminal values. Happiness, satisfaction in life. If you follow those instrumental values, you will be somewhere feeling happy and satisfied and contented in the life. Otherwise, whatever you may do, you will not be happy. A person can be happy with less possessions. I am not against possessions. A person can be happy, unhappy with more possessions. Termination value kya hai? Knowledge and wisdom. Knowledge leading to wisdom rather. Peace and harmony in the world. Peace. Shanti. Harmony. If you are not in a state of peace, terminal value hai ye. You are all the time fighting. हमारे को फौज की जरूरत नहीं है. We do not require army. If we are having peace and harmony in our bordering countries, जैसे चाइना और पाकिस्तान के साथ हमारी यदि harmonious relation है, we need not invest our time, energy, manpower, whatever we are spending on our army and its training and retraining. Peace. If there is a fight between the two brothers, fight between the two colleagues, if there is a fight between two brothers, what happens? The home suffers. Ghar mein ashanti hoti hai. Whole economic, the harmony in the family, everyone is suffering. There cannot be happiness. If there is a peace, thode mein bhi gujara hota hai. Aur jadi thodi si bhi ladai hoti hai, fir who takes the benefit? Lawyers. court mein case jaate hain. Who takes the benefit? Third party. America is taking benefit of fight between India and Pakistan and China. Uske weapons bik rahe hain. Italy ke weapons bik rahe hain. Pride in accomplishment is a terminal value. Prosperity. Prosperity is going to come automatically, terminal value hai ye. Lasting friendships. Yes, lasting friendship, terminal value hai ye. But then you have to have selfless love for the friend. Then recognition from peers. Spiritual living. Security. Many of us are suffering for two problems. Individuality crisis, you are not able to identify yourself, identity crisis, and insecurities. They happen because somewhere our value system go wrong. These are the true criteria. I will not go in the details. What should be the value which is accepted in any organization or in any system? Test of universalizability. Those values jo ke universe, large population ke liye apply ho sake. This is number one criteria. Another criteria of what is right or what is wrong is there's nothing right or wrong. So these are the two parameters, universalizability and then greater good for greater number. Maximum good should be the value which is good for large number of people and greatest good to that large number. Those are the two values. Those are two criteria for accepting a value. I will again now go little fast from here. Yes. But then these are the important values which we can consider to be imbibed in ourselves and also in our students. Three C's. seven D's, starting from devotion to detachment. Seven F's. The first F is very important. Follow one's own consciousness. Aapke andar ki still small voice inside you, that inner value. Six P's. From purity, patience, peace, pity, punctuality, and perseverance. Six R's. Respect to responsibility. Eleven S. So wonderful, my dear friends. See, we have four list of values which fulfill the criteria, those two criteria I have mentioned before. Self-realization or self-actualization. Self-sacrifice. Thodi-thodi sacrifice. And other human values or virtues are love, affection, equality, generosity. Be generous. Nobility, justice, kindness, humility, modesty, non-violence. Non-violence is again very important. I will not be violent, not only physically, mentally and emotionally non-violent to others. Gentleness is a prerequisite for being empathetic to others or being compassionate to others. You cannot be compassionate to others or being empathic. Exercise nahi kar sakte jab tak ki gentleness nahi hai. So my dear friends, these are the values which are being talked about in the new education policy also. I have talked largely in details. So I will not go in the details. Value education ke baare mein bhi main zyada baat nahi karna chahta, but I like to cover some of the important things which are left in this session before the time is out. My dear friends, you know, jo basics hai hamare value based spiritual education hai, uski baat karenge abhi. Value based spiritual education. I am not talking about any religion here. Though all religion talk about spirituality, but I am talking about pure spirituality here in its essence. Why education? Because we want to catch our youngsters at a younger age before they become the habits, habitual of reflecting those characters. We have to catch them. Your parents, teachers, family members, school, environment, everyone, religion, every media, everyone influence on the child. So we need to teach at a very younger age, encourage them to play certain sports, games, yoga. Games are to develop sportsman spirit. Sportsman spirit ki maine aapko shuru mein ek video dikhayi thi, choti si. You can understand what the sports teaches you. Besides physical wellness, yoga, dance, gymnastics, all have them to teach the certain values in the life. Dance itself is a art which imbibes in itself so many values. Academics, co-curricular and extracurricular activity help teach in values. A lot of emphasis should be paid on the co-curricular and extracurricular. NSS, NCC, tree plantation, blood donation, all those, so many co-curricular and extracurricular activity which imbibes the values in the student. Then meditation, music, self-analysis, introspection, positive affirmations, resolutions help in improving our character. Your communication, my dears, and the word which you speak or write, parents and other affect our character. And that's why right and appropriate communication is very important, especially to the youngest persons in the family. Do not be ever rude. Be kind in your communications. टीचर्स आर लाइक साइन पोस्ट, वो बच्चे को किसी डायरेक्शन में भी ले जा सकते हैं. कोचिज कैन मेक ए प्लेयर, इट कैन डिस्ट्रॉय ए प्लेयर. सिमिलरली टीचर कैन मेक ए स्टूडेंट और इट कैन डिस्ट्रॉय ए स्टूडेंट. यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड एंड देन यू मस्ट प्रैक्टिस आल्सो. माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, काइंडली सी दिस, यू माइट हैव हर्ड इट अर्लियर आल्सो, थॉट्स एंड डेस्टिनी. Thoughts, they become your words. Be watchful of your thoughts. Words, they become your actions. Be watchful of your words, which you use in your communication. Watch your actions because they become your habits. Be watchful of your actions. Be watchful of your habits. They become your characters. And character becomes your destiny. If you want to be destined to be a good, you watch your thoughts, watch your words, watch your actions, watch your habits. One thing leads to other. Words leads to action. Action leads to habits. Habit leads to character. And character leads to destiny. We cannot blame our destiny if we are not watchful of our thoughts, words, actions, and habits. My dear, present scenario in our curriculum is more towards materiality. कितना पैकेज मिलने वाला है, कार मिलेगी, TATA कितना मिलेगा, हाउस मिलेगा, ऑल मटीरियल. एम्फेसिस ऑन मटीरियल, वेरी लेस एम्फेसिस ऑन स्पिरिचुअलिटी विच वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट जस्ट नाउ. एंड सेंट्स क्या कहते हैं, दे गिव लॉट ऑफ एम्फेसिस ऑन स्पिरिचुअलिटी, दे गिव लॉट ऑफ वेट टू द स्पिरिचुअलिटी, ओनली ऑन स्पिरिचुअलिटी. What is required is equilibrium. You require a good house, you require clothes, you require food to eat, and you require spirituality. So if you are able to develop an equilibrium in our curriculum, in our classroom instructions, in our off the classroom instructions, co-curricular and extracurricular activities of the students, between materiality and spirituality, we will be able to have a value-based education, which is all about the value-based education is all about. The progress should be, the progress will be only when we are able to develop, we are able to merge. We have actually drawn lines, but there is actually no line between materiality and spirituality. They go hand in hand together. When we are able to have cohesion of these two, we will be able to. And yoga is one of the ways where we are having this union of material and spiritual. Ashtang yoga, from asana to samadhi, yam to samadhi. I like to close the first part of my presentations here. A person starts to live when he can live outside him. Einstein said that. And to solve a problem, get out of the problem. If you are entangled in the problem, you become part of the problem. You have to see outside that problem, the solutions are there. And be a guest at your home, my dear. Be a guest. We are all guests in this home, in this universe. This universe. Understand and remember this very well. Kya leke aaye hain, kya hain, kya leke jayenge. It is not enough to be busy. The question is, what are we busy about? Understand ourselves. Manage self. And can we take decisions? And can we develop our personality?
आगे इनकी एलैबोरेशन है माय फ्रेंड्स, टाइम मैनेजमेंट, स्टाफ मैनेजमेंट में क्या कुछ है एंड बिजनेस डेवलपमेंट में क्या कुछ है।
I like to close my presentations here, my dear friends, about the health and happiness. I have complete set of slides and session on that also. But largely, I would say, health ke andar we can understand that health is not disease. If you are remaining free from disease, you are healthy. No. It is a complete package of your physical, your mental, your emotional, and your spiritual well-being. Living at its peak is the healthy. And there are so many ways. Your physical activities, your exercise, your diet, your intellectual self, your meditation, you know, all those things contribute to your complete well-being. And once you are completely well-being, you can be happy. You can be happy when your inside is happy, not only your outside happiness is also important, but then more than that, your inner peace, contentment are the main things to reflect that happiness. It is said that an average teacher teaches, a good teacher explains, an excellent teacher inspires by being a role model. A bad teacher only complains. Now you see for yourself, out of 24 hours, how much time you are spending in teaching, in explaining, and imbibing all those characteristics in your own personality, and be a role model and inspire your students. And how much time you are spending as a complainant. Pani nahi hai, bijli nahi hai, ye nahi hai, students ki IQ kam hai, classroom mein ye nahi hai, laboratory mein equipment nahi hai, material nahi hai. You know, we have so many bag full of complaints. But how much time we spend in our which category do I belong? I am not giving you answer. Have a introspection, and that introspection should go on every day in and day out. And my dear friends, the key to happiness is we are in charge of our happiness. Happiness comes from within. It is a state of mind. Stop worrying. Appreciate simple things. Focus on what we have. Your social, emotional, and spiritual quotient are more important than your intelligence quotient, IQ. Live in the present moment. Do good to others. When you do good to others, you drive happiness. Physical activity. Read. Music. Travel. Sports. Your hobby. Pursue your hobbies. Have no malice, hatred, vindictive attitude, revengeful attitude. Forgive self and forgive others. Sleep with a dream and wake up with a purpose, enlightenment. My dear friends, I like to close my session here, and I like to pray to the Almighty God to lead you a happy and a healthy life. If there are any questions in your mind, my dear friends, I like to answer your questions here. You can put your questions or you can give your comments in the chat box.
So we have some questions.
Okay. One of the biggest tools to teach the new generation is to inspire. First of all, we have to imbibe. If I want my son not to smoke, I have to quit smoking myself. If I want my students to be punctual, I have to be punctual in my classroom. If I want my, you know, whatever you want to teach or educate your students or your children or your neighbors, you have to imbibe those in your own self. And slowly and gently appreciate them, go to their level and try. It should not be only verbal, oral sermons. Moral and ethical are the prerequisite for good character, but kindly focus on the slides, my beginning slides, your nobility in character, your chastity in character, your devoutness, your decency, all those things have to be, they are all together. It is a complete package. Jaise ek hum kehne ek full diet hai, uske andar you require not only protein, calcium, your all minerals, your all ingredients, the complete diet is required to survive this body. Similarly, all those characteristics are required to be a complete character. How to control anger is $1 million question Divam has asked. Divya has asked, how to control your anger? By respecting yourself and by respecting others. There is no shortcut to that. When you are able to respect the difference of opinions, the acceptability level, okay, isme hi guzara hai. When you are able to respect not only persons, but the situations as it is, then you can be less angry. How can we improve our health in this time when the screen time is increased a lot? Our children and in fact we are also affected in the long run. I agree with you 200% on this. The screen time should be minimized. Screen time should be minimized. Ye hamari compulsion hai abhi ki we are increasing our screen time. And technology is coming. And we should continuously do research when the effects of screen time can be minimized. Jaise medicine ke andar side effects hain, similarly hamara screen time ke andar bhi side effects hain to our eyes and our health also. But then if the medicines are made similarly, if the technology can be there where we can have least side effects from our screen time, that can be. But then definitely our screen time is affecting our health. It is no substitute to contact mode. I have recently joined teaching. What I find, sir, not all, but some students have less moral values. My question is, how do I help them to achieve that being? Manisha ji ne question pucha ye wala. Ma'am, aap apne level pe, apni classroom mein, apni beyond the classroom mein, जो भी आपके कॉन्टेक्ट में आ रहा है, whosoever is coming in your contact, try to do your best. You cannot change the whole world. The whole world will be changed by bringing about that change in yourself and the persons around you get the inspiration around you. If student irritate us, how manage that situation? There is a perfect immunization system for that irritant also. Try to identify that somewhere problem is not outside. What irritates you is the problem is usually not outside. Something is inside you and somebody is just pressing the trigger. Barood andar hai. Kisne trigger daba diya wo. Wo trigger ko aap control kariye. We can be taking a full session on that also, man. But then, your long meditation, being self-awareness can help you in not getting pressed about the triggers. It affects your health also. छोटी सी की प्रॉब्लम आई एंड यू आर हैविंग जुकाम खांसी ये वो कोरोना एंड व्हाई देयर एम्फसाइजिंग नाउ इम्यूनाइजेशन बिकॉज देन कोरोना कैन नॉट इफेक्ट यू सिमिलरली योर मेंटल इम्यूनाइजेशन योर इमोशनल इम्यूनाइजेशन आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड दे कैन बी प्रैक्टिस बाय मेडिटेशन बाय डीप ब्रीदिंग बाय प्रैक्टिसिंग योगा एंड देयर मेनी अदर वेज आल्सो Yes, if you are able to inspire your student to read and self-study, you have done your job. And slowly, you can build up your teaching profession itself also, your subject matter also. More than your subject matter, if you can make your student understand the significance of the topic, nowadays the information and the knowledge is available in the Google and in many other things. But then you yourself also need to grow and you should be able to facilitate the problem solving of the students also. Yes. You need to grow. Thank you so much. And I think it is now time also. Manisha, you have been such a great help for conducting this session. Thank you so much. And my participants, we have, as you can see, 188 slides. I could share with you only maybe a couple of them. Some other time, my dear friend, we will talk about in details about more things. Thank you so much and all the very best.
Thank you very much, sir. For interacting with all the participants, there is one participant, sir, who raised his hand. So, can we take the question of that participant also, Dr. Vikrama?
Okay.
Manisha, can you please connect us with Dr. Vikrama?
Dr. Vikrama will be able to speak now. Hello. Yes. Yeah, actually some people press the buttons just like that also, they don't understand sometimes. Anyway, I am so thankful to my colleagues for giving me this opportunity. I wish I had more time available with me to share really the inside things of happiness and health also. But broadly I have covered. Thank you so much, Alka ji. Thank you so much to my other participants for appreciating my session here. And you can have my email or my phone number from the coordinator of this program. And if you have some specific questions, I can share my viewpoints on that also. Should we stop here, Manisha ji?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Yes. Manisha, my mic is not on. Yes. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you so much, Aman ji. Thank you so much, Manisha ji, once again.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you.
Thank you very much, sir.